Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Round Table here at the range. Now, today we've actually got a fun experiment that we thought of at the end of last night. We threw two guns into a freezer. One was a Springer with a spring, and one was a gas piston. I've brought the smartest people that I know. I got Tyler Patner, I got the Godfather here, and of course the airgun scientist Joe Brancato to explain what's gonna happen as we shoot these guns cold and then hot. We're gonna start cold, and then we're gonna shoot them hot, and one's literally being run in from the freezer right now as we speak. What do we got here? How you doing, sir? Appreciate it. Oh,
that's cold.
So this is the Ruger Air Magnum 177.
All right.
Guys, what do we expect to happen right now as this is cold?
Stick your tongue to it.
Yeah. So just so we know, this is a 10.3 grain pellet.
Yep.
So the expectation, I think it's been well put out there in the airgun industry that a gas piston is not affected by cold, the spring gun is.
Not that much.
Well, a lot of companies have put that out there.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily what's been found.
Okay, just for the record, it's very cold.
Sounded pretty decent.
1,000 feet a second.
1,000 feet a second. 1,002 feet a second.
1,002 to be exact. Yes. 967.
967.
Interesting.
90. 544. Now that's interesting. As she's warming up. She's dropping.
Yeah. Yep.
It's coming.
980. You're good. 934.
Right. 954.
954. 951.
948. 947.
Okay, 948.
947,
you're right. Yeah,
948.
Wow, so that's...
Here comes the next
rifle. So I think we give this a little time, let it get kind of outdoor temperature here.
I'll take that.
952.
Yeah, let's see what this gas ram does.
So that's pretty...
So this
thing is,
that was the spring gun.
That was the spring gun.
With a spring.
Now the interesting thing is how consistent it got once it warmed up.
Right.
This one's cold again.
Yeah. And this is a Umarex
22.
Octane.
Yeah,
this
is the octane.
14 and a half grain RWS Super Dot.
Okay, first shot was 775. It even sounds 773.
But
it
I'm gonna tell you, slow. This thing is accurate.
777. 786. It's getting faster, but it is. 789.
No, it was low. It was like 750.
Yeah, 790. 801. 802.
Oh, wow, it's climbing.
Get up into Alaska and this.
801.
They get them
so this is climbing, consistently climbing and getting more and more consistent. It started around 750 and now it's moved up to 800.
Yeah. Yep.
That other one started at 1,000 and worked its way down.
Yeah, that's interesting.
And then stabilized around 850, 950.
950. All right, so let's say we give it what? An hour, a couple hours?
Let's do it.
Yeah, to pull it dry and come back and see?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, it's been a couple hours.
Yeah.
We've shot some other segments.
We have.
Maybe. It depends on how much oil's in there.
I'm not gonna lie, this was smooth. It was cocking smoother when it was frozen.
Interesting. All right, let's see if there's an impact here.
All right, so we're starting with a 22.
And we were doing what, 700?
Right around 800 there towards the end, right?
Yeah. And you got 854, so there you go. Oh.
854. Yeah.
841, not surprising.
Putting them right in there.
870, 869. 868.7.
Okay, so this is...
Bottom line, it's going faster.
Yeah. It's going a lot faster. Yeah. Over 100 feet per second change from right out of the freezer to warm.
Yep.
That's
a lot.
More than we thought? Or
Way more than we thought.
Still spring. It was at 1,000.
It's 1,000 initially, and then it went down, right? As it got warmed up. Would it end up mid-9s?
Mid-9s.
High
950.
Yeah. And this one's coming in at 992?
Yeah.
You can factor chronograph.
Let's see, 1,002.
1,002.
Okay, so it's right back where we thought
it would
be.
Right back where it started. First shot was 1,002 or three.
So Tom, right now, I want to know what's going through your mind.
Ain't working like I thought it would.
1,007.
I've tested this before.
Right,
yeah.
As have I. 1,008.
So what is the, what then let's make a new rule. What's the new rule? So,
the new rule is shut your mouth.
I will say this from shooting it.
Yeah.
The gas piston was still way more accurate, frozen and thawed. So there you go, guys, rule of thumb. Don't put your gun in the freezer.
Don't believe everything you read.
Don't believe everything you read. Don't put your gun in the freezer. That's it for this round table out here at the range. Again, I think we've proven, here's the thing. The gas piston is affected more by the cold than a spring piston is. Go to AmericanAirGunner.com with more questions, more videos, more fun. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.
After this, it's time for some DIY. Nothing like a good old-fashioned booby trap.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to American Air Gunner DIY. This is some of my favorite segments. We've DIY'd a few things in our day, and today we've got a good one. This is called the BAM Scram. It is a trip-line detonator using a big blast cap from Umarex. So basically, here's how it works. You need a big, giant rat trap. It's a Victor, just like this, Victor Giant V. You actually want this one because it'll come in handy later. You need a 3/16 piece of plywood. You need a piece of rope. Now this can be a fishing line. You need a rubber band. You need four little zip ties. And then you need a big long zip tie. You also want a big screw. This is gonna be your detonator, your firing pin essentially, and you need three wood screws to attach it to a board later, and you need a small piece of wood about this shape and size, and you can get these actual dimensions. You want to go on AmericanAirGunner.com and you want to download the instructions, but mostly you want this. So first and foremost, here's what the rat trap looks like. I've done some of the work early because you guys don't want to watch me drill holes and silly stuff. All right, look at that. Page two is this little piece, and it's a 4.5 by 2.25. Cut this to size, just like so. Do the drilling. Ta-da! Just like that. So see, now you've got all the holes that you need. When you get your rat trap, the first thing you wanna do is you have to remove this. This is what holds down, essentially the firing pin thing here that allows the trap to detonate. Now then, you wanna take this little piece of board right here, and the instructions are exactly how big, but you wanna put it on the end here. The idea is that when this comes down, because it comes down with so much force, and you've lost so much power here, that this will break. So you just reinforce it, so glue it, and then screw it in, like so, just to reinforce this part of your trap. You wanna take this little piece earlier that we made, right, out of the plywood, and you wanna slide it under, okay? So the notch goes out, like so, and you just wanna slide it in. And then you'll see that it'll kind of all line up. All right, so there you go. So now you've got this section ready to go. All right, so once you get this on, it's kind of good because you've got this big piece of wood here, so you can just kind of bring this back and then grab you a little clamp like so. Clamp that down, and now you can work freely. All right, so I've got all this tied up and it'll make sense later, but what you want to do first of all is you want to get a rubber band and you want to take your line, wire, whatever you want to use as your tripwire, and you want to tie it to the rubber band. And from that knot, you want to measure out 2.5 inches, and remember that little trigger pin that we were talking about earlier that we took off of the mousetrap? You want to run it through the little piece here and you want to clamp it down. And then you want to run this from underneath the mousetrap, you want to run it back in here, and we just want to reinstall it. And then you're going to take this rubber band, and you're going to put with the hole underneath. So the hole's underneath where the knot is, and it runs up here to this guy. So the idea being that when you get to here, right? So that's how it runs, and then that's how it's set. So that's gonna be your tripwire. So it pulls on the rubber band, and then it pulls on that to keep from it yanking out. The idea being, if something comes and runs along really fast, and you just had it going straight to this little, the firing pin, it would just rip the line out. So you tie it to the rubber band, it pulls, and 2.5 inches is the magic number. So 2.5 inches from this knot into here is where you clamp it down. Like this, all right? Like that's how it's set, okay? See this? And then whoosh, smashes forward. Now, how does it detonate? That's where this little screw right here comes in, and by little I mean big fat screw, okay? So this is the screw you're gonna drive through. There's only one more hole here on your board, and you're just gonna take this, it shouldn't be going through anything except that one little board. So now that is your firing pin. As you can see, it sticks out just a little bit there, right? So we're gonna mount the bottle like so. So when this comes in, it pops the bottle, boom, big blast cap does what it does, big noise, and whatever you just either scared runs off. Okay, so that's how you make the trap. So how do we install the bottle? Well, we'll be right back. All right, so we've got the bottle in there. Here we go, nice and tight. You get the wire coming out from the back, like this. It still pulls your tripwire, so your tripwire will run like this. And then whenever something comes through, it'll release, come through, the screw goes through it through the bottle, hits, big bang. You guys ready? Let's roll. You're walking. Bam! Scram!
You've been watching American Airgunner, the only televised show all about air guns. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe at AmericanAirGunner.com. Now engage your brain and go shoot an air gun.
Ow. Where's my camera? You? You. You?